Hey guys, if you don't have this game yet and want to play, simply like this video and leave a comment down below. Winners will be picked and announced this weekend. Good luck. So we have a massive list to go through of what's believed to be characters coming to this game. But let me ask you a question. If you could pick one hero from the Marvel Universe, who would it be and why? Let me know down below in that comments section. How's it going, guys? My name is DPJ, and if you enjoy your stay here and would like to show your support, hitting that like button truly helps out. And subscribe if you like what you see and want to see more. Okay, with so many new players coming to the game, many of them not knowing about this information, I thought I'd bring it to the fresh eyes of this community. Before this game was released, data miners, as they do, went into the files of the game, basically extracting details on heroes believed to be coming to the game due to ties within the files to things like having unlocked cards and being referred to as unlockable characters. And there are 15 in total, one of them being confirmed by the devs themselves that she is indeed the first on the list of playable characters that will be coming. So let's check out these heroes and what they can do. So firstly, we know Kate Bishop is coming. So who is Kate Bishop, you are wondering? Well, for this it's simple, and I will let them themselves explain this to you.
Avengers, good. There's someone who wants to talk to you. I believe some of you know Kate Bishop.
Oh, we've met.
Are you working for S.H.I.E.L.D. now?
It's, complicated.
Where's Clint?
That's complicated, too. Clint and I were looking into what happened to Director Fury after A-Day. We stumbled on this Tachyon project, and then Clint was gone, too. That.
Our guest finally agreed to help.
Remember what's riding on this.
Easy, Doc. Deal's a deal. I'll do my part.
Clint?
We need to destroy that place.
No.
Okay, how's this?
I am Thor, God of Thunder.
That is not what I sound like.
Taking AIM is the first big post-launch operation. It directly advances the story starting at the conclusion of the Reassemble campaign. We are so excited to share that the first Avenger to join our expanded roster is Kate Bishop. We love Kate. She's smart, incredibly talented, and a master archer. Given the strong connection and friendship between Kate and Clint, we knew we couldn't do one without the other. Taken together, we like to think of their individual hero operations as a double feature. For some background, Clint, the original Hawkeye, took on Kate as a protege. But in many ways, Kate is the mature one. She's like the smarter younger sister who has to clean up the messes of her reckless older brother. In the Taking AIM operation, you'll get a new hero, Kate Bishop, complete with her own set of skills, gear, and moves to unlock and master just like the core launch heroes. You'll also get a brand new story and villain that adds to the ever-expanding Avengers Initiative experience. While operations are a way to introduce new heroes, villains, and more story, they can also add new regions to the globe.
So you guys, I cannot wait for that. So who else was data mined? 14 others, guys, so let's check them out. And we're going to start with Captain Marvel as well as Mar-Val. And well, if you guys watched a Captain Marvel movie, you should have no problem knowing who these are. I mean, Captain Marvel is all over the game via posters. I mean, just go to Miss Marvel's room, aka Kamala Khan, and you'll see a poster of Captain Marvel on her wall. And well, I think as one of the main movie characters too, it was inevitable that she was coming. Mar-Val though is a little different. And well, early on guys, Mar-Val was originally Captain Marvel and was also a man. In the movie that changed. So it will be interesting to see how he or she will be portrayed in the game. So Mar-Val, or Captain Mar-Val, is Kree and has genius level intellect, a master scientist and engineer. Also has superhuman strength, durability and agility, and regenerative healing. So it's going to be interesting to see what role she plays within the game. And like Kate Bishop and Clint, we might see Captain Marvel and Mar-Val come together, but might not both be playable characters, like it seems Hawkeye ain't, just Kate. But we will see. Okay, so next up, people, we have She-Hulk, who, as we know, is basically a female Hulk. And originally, as far as I can remember, she is Bruce Banner's cousin, and he gave her some of his blood to save her life. And then she became the She-Hulk. Original name of Jennifer Walters, and well, like I said, her powers are basically the same as the Hulk's. But it will be interesting to see how they release her into the game and the story that follows suit. Okay, so next up, people, we have War Machine, who, well, I guess you all know about. This, I would imagine, will be tied into some kind of story featuring mainly Tony, which would be cool, but in actual fact, guys, it could also be tied to Captain Marvel. As you may not know, but they actually had a love fling within the comics. And depending on how they want to drop the story, or any story for that matter, we could see a few sides of this thing. One thing to remember though, the War Machine armor was never as powerful as the Iron Man armor, hence why Tony Stark never saw a need to use it. And I'm actually curious to see how things play out with War Machine, because although War Machine is indeed as heroic as they come, there was a brief period I do remember where War Machine was indeed a villain. Can't remember who played this part, wasn't Rhodey though, but we will see. Interesting to think about the many different angles they could play out here. Okay, so next up we have another two heroes which tie directly into what we have already played so far in the game, and they are Ant-Man and the Wasp. Being confirmed throughout the story that Hank Pym can't no longer shrink down, it's quite obvious that we will see Scott Lang take on the form of Ant-Man. Now, the Wasp in the movie was originally Janet Van Dyne, who was played by Hank Pym's wife. Yet his daughter also played the role in the movie too as the Wasp. But I actually remember the daughter from the comics as Red Queen. So who will we get in the game? His wife, his daughter? It's anyone's guess. Mother or daughter though, it would be interesting. But if we do get Hope as the Wasp, I do hope we get a Red Queen suit for her. That would be cool. Okay, so next up, people, we have none other than Black Panther. R.I.P. Chadwick. For me, Black Panther was always going to come, and to be honest, I honestly cannot wait. And I can say this character will truly be one of the best additions to ever come to this game, and well, I feel most people will agree with me. So some of what the Black Panther can do. The power to draw upon the knowledge, strength, and every experience from every previous Black Panther. Superhuman strength, speed, reflexes, agility, stamina, endurance, durability, and senses. Genius level intellect, master martial artist, tactician, strategist, and inventor. Utilizing that vibranium suit and equipment. I mean, so yeah, this is going to be a great addition, and I honestly cannot wait for the Black Panther. Okay, so next up, people, we have Doctor Strange, aka Stephen Strange, who is another Avenger we kinda knew had to be dropped into the game. Now, playable characters like Doctor Strange for me are truly exciting considering what this guy actually does. It's why I like using 4 because everything is just a spectacle. Now, without doubt, Doctor Strange will be another flying character, as with Captain Marvel, War Machine, and the Wasp. I welcome more. And I can see now some of the combos involving the Cloak of Levitation and hopefully Dragon Fang 2, his sword. But yeah, I don't think I need to go on more about Doctor Strange. I think we all know of this character and I think we all will look forward to him. Okay, so next up we have the Falcon, aka Snap Wilson, aka Blackwing, and aka, well, at one stage or another, Captain America. So yeah, the Falcon, Sam Wilson, will be added into the game at some stage or another according to these data mined files. And well, I guess he will be tied in with a Captain America storyline. Now quickly before we move on, because I don't think I need to go on about the Falcon either, and the next character we're going to talk about also ties into Captain America, I do wonder if they will acknowledge Falcon's telepathic links with all birds. I mean, we didn't see anything like this in the movies, but it would be interesting to see it somehow incorporated into the game via his skill set. That would be amazing. Okay, so next up, and another tie-in to Captain America, we have the Winter Soldier. Which, don't hate me for this, people, I still feel the Winter Soldier is the best Marvel movie made to date. I mean, man, I love that film. Now, James Bucky Barnes, like Captain America, is a super soldier. Interesting though, I don't think he was ever referred to as the Winter Soldier when the partner of Captain America. He was only referred to as the Winter Soldier when this dude was a brainwashed assassin for the Russians. So the mere fact the Winter Soldier is coming, it's going to be really interesting to see who we actually get. Will he be introduced as the Winter Soldier as a villain as we play as him and progress through the story that comes with him? Will he turn hero? Pretty cool to think about. Okay, so next up we have the Mockingbird, aka Barbara Bobby Morse, or Barbara Barton. Yes, Mockingbird is the divorcee wife of Clint Barton, aka Hawkeye. So this is interesting for sure. Now the ex part of the wife comes, I believe, due to a falling out over Mockingbird letting someone fall off a cliff and die. I think the villain here was called the Phantom Rider. But yes, she is a true, proper superhero, and she will be a great addition to the game. Now some of her powers consist of, she is proficient in armed hand-to-hand combat, she's an espionage, she also does that gymnastics, and she's a martial artist. Enhanced strength and ability, healing and halted aging. And also expert marksman and mastery of various other weapons, especially her trademark two battle staves. So she's going to be a great addition for sure. Okay, so moving on, and next up we have Quake, aka Daisy Johnson. So Quake, you might recall from the series Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., and besides Nick Fury and Black Widow, she is the only other level 10 clearance S.H.I.E.L.D. agent. Me personally, I remember her mostly for her ties to Kamala Khan, aka Miss Marvel, in the Inhuman Secret Warriors comic. But it will be interesting to see how she's incorporated into the game. Her special powers, vibration, manipulation, expert spy and martial artist. Okay, so we're going to move on. And lastly, I might as well drop these two as a pair, even though they've had many, many more instances apart in the comics. But for the sake of the movies, and probably 50% of people watching this more so know them from the movies over the comics, they are Scarlet Witch and Vision. Both of these heroes are literally stupid powerful, and besides maybe even Captain Marvel on the list, I don't think any other heroes could even put up a fight to either of these two. So we'll start with Scarlet Witch, and something seriously interesting about her, I still don't think many people know. She is the daughter of Magneto, and obviously the sister of Quicksilver too. And in the early days, I even think her costume resembled Magneto's. Now Wanda's powers are off the charts, and here are some of her abilities. She has scientifically enhanced magical abilities, reality warping, probability manipulation, teleportation, matter manipulation, time manipulation, energy projection, and absorption. So when she eventually does come, it's going to be super interesting for sure to see what she's capable of and the story she brings at the same time. Okay, so Vision. So where do we start with this dude? Well, according to the movies, which is a lot different to some of the much better versions I have read, Vision was basically created by Ultron, who was created by Tony Stark, using the Mind Stone's power, etc, 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 etc. Now, a more interesting take on this, and a much better backstory in my opinion, and the one I mostly remember. Ultron, or Ultron 5, was actually created by Hank Pym. Ultron rebelled against him and the Avengers, and Ultron wanting to get revenge against them, he took a vessel of the Human Torch. And he was modified, memories wiped, and then became Vision. Because those of you who do not know, the Human Torch was originally an android. But yeah, Vision actually being Human Torch, or an android version of the Human Torch, is so much more interesting to me. And yes, this is the same Human Torch who was later taken by Stanley, I believe, and incorporated into the Fantastic Four comics. But yeah, Vision, either way, whichever version we get, is going to be absolutely amazing. And I also hope we get Grey Vision too, because that suit was incredible. And yeah, guys, that is it. All 14 or 15 characters believe via Datamine to be coming to the game. And for the most part, I cannot wait. Tell me down below in that comment section who's your favourite off this list and you cannot wait for. My top 5, I'd probably say Black Panther, Doctor Strange, Captain Marvel, War Machine, and Scarlet Witch. But hey, that's just my opinion. But on that note, guys, we have come to the end of the video. If you guys enjoyed it, leaving a like really helps out. If you're new around here and want to see more Marvel's Avengers, be sure to subscribe. And if you never want to miss a video I upload, you can turn notifications on by hitting that bell button. But guys, thanks as always for stopping by. Hopefully you enjoyed the video, and hopefully I will see you on that next one.